What's up, operators? So we're here, it's day two. We got the approval yesterday for the demolition of the wastewater treatment plant. Insurance labeled it a total loss. We need to get this plant out of the ground, into dumpsters, and clear it. We're in the works of purchasing our new plant that I've been working on for almost 2 years. I've been designing, working hand in hand with the engineers out of the AUC group to fabricate a bigger, better plant for this resort. It's gonna be a lot of work. A lot of stuff's gotta go away. I just wanna give you guys a quick insight on what we got going on here. Here we are, about a week into the process, and we've got pretty much all of the plastic stripped out of both trains. There was the CCC. We've cut that up. We've already filled a 30-yard dumpster. And looks like what we're gonna do is just probably have a wrecker come in with a couple cranes, lift each one of these tanks as we cut them away, and haul them out of here in one piece to a scrapyard. That's gonna save us time, and it's gonna be a cleaner job than having pieces of steel that we have to lay into the dumpster. And we're not getting a deal on the steel because steel's so cheap right now. I think at right now, November 2017, is going for a penny a pound. And this whole plant could go for maybe $1,200. It's not much money, but getting rid of it's more valuable to us. So chipping away at the day and getting the Influent EQ ready, taking what we need, floats and all that for the new plant. Yesterday I went to the village of Isla Morada and got us set up for our building permit for our foundation. It went really well, and hopefully we get that back soon and we can start putting the foundation down in our new plant. So we're here pre-game day, setting up to trim off the last little bit of the Influent EQ to make the size fit the permit. We had to get a permit 12 foot high to pull this tank out of here. That's how I got in here. And it is about 11 foot 8. So David's just trimming the last little bits off here so we can prep for tomorrow, 9 a.m. Crane's gonna be here, and they're gonna set up right here, and then the low boy will come in and sit right next to it, and there's an eye hook over there, an eye hook over here, and they're just gonna lift this up. Hey, dude, we got a fire in there.
So here everybody is arrived, the crane operator, the towing guys here, and the Coffs Towing doesn't think that they're going to be able to maneuver the tank out of Chica Lodge because of the narrow pathway we have going through.
That's better be get in here and back down that way first. If it's up here, then you've got less room to maneuver.
I've got to stretch that thing out another
20 foot. If we pick it,
then I can't get out there. If I stretch out, then I'm not going to be able to get in there. Get out. The only way I can get out is I can pick it, turn it over, pick it, turn it over.
Good
luck. Back of the trailer. The only way I'm going to get out on the road is the same way. We'll be right back.
So because the trailer stretched out was approximately 95 feet long, it couldn't make the turn going out of onto the old highway. So we had the crane follow and pick up the back of the trailer with the tank on it and move it over 4 feet so that he could clear the rocks to get back out on the old highway. Here we were over the size of the permit, which is 12 foot by 4 inches, with the tank being on the trailer. So we had to lop off the steel on the top of the tank. We also had to blow some holes into the side of the tank to secure the tank to the trailer so it didn't roll over.